Through hell, fire, and brimstone, Kane is back. He's back in Series 74. Hey, it's Wrestling Hero Figs. Nice to see this man back. Yeah, he's back. Series 74, great, great series. I picked this up from walkoutwear.com using discount code HERO, H-E-R-O. Yeah, that'll save you some pretty good chunk. A lot of great figures in this series. I do like this a lot. This figure, man, I'm going to tell you, this long-awaited figure for a lot of people. Because if you guys remember, he was released in Elite Series 12, right? And, well, you guys know the cost of the guy, right? He's $70 on eBay, tried picking this man up. So, yeah, save yourself some money, right? Walkoutwear's got this figure available. But, like I said, using discount code HERO, you're going to save yourself quite a bit of money. And I did want to do a quick review on the timeline, right? Because, man, he's had some great gimmicks, right? We had the dentist. We had Diesel. Yeah, Diesel. He was repackaged as Diesel when Diesel had gone over to WCW. So, they repackaged him. And this is kind of like the path to WWE Gold, as my good friend Beast Nation said. After that, I don't want to see necessarily downhill, but once he started unmasking himself, because yeah, I don't know what the writers of WWE were thinking, because he lost something once he took that mask off. This was the first stage of becoming unmasked, and then he became fully unmasked, and then he stopped doing the eye darkness, and I don't know, man. And then, I don't want to get into Corporate Kane too much, because I feel like Corporate Kane, probably the worst character out of just this. Yankum is up there, but definitely Corporate Kane. Oh, man, Man, they really just completely destroyed it, right? So, here he is, Kane. So, there are some differences apart from being basic and elite, right? So, again, this is a great series. Overall, a great series. All the figures available in the set. And Kane right here, he's ready to come out of the box. I hate to get him out of the box because this box is in mint condition. The way that Walkoutwear packages these is just incredible. We're going to get it out because I do want to do a quick comparison. And there goes Diesel. See, Diesel got mad that he got repackaged. So now he's into knocking down every other Kane that tried taking his place, right? So, all right. This figure right here, this is awesome. I like this a lot. I always wanted to create that moment. That moment when Undertaker played as fake Kane, because that's what happened. It was Undertaker and also Luke Gallows. He also played as fake Kane. So this is the figure that kind of represents that. Because I mean, Undertaker's got that full tattoo sleeve, right? And well, Gallows, I mean, the man's covered in tattoos himself. So what they did to kind of play it as fake Kane, they just put a full sleeve on the man. They put a full arm sleeve on the left. Come on, he's really in there. He doesn't want to get out. He's like, I want to be mock. I want to be mint in cart. So, yeah, he put on this sleeve to kind of mask the tattoos because they are pretty much the exact same height. I mean, they're close to the seven foot mark. And, wow, this is cool. This is really awesome. I like this figure a lot. Again, apart from the sleeve, I'm noticing right off the bat that the design right here on the chest, it's a little bit higher. The Elite has it kind of out here. Let me remove the belt. It has it a little bit lower. If you look at it close enough, these kind of go a lot lower. The wrist gauntlets, they're pretty much the exact same right here. This is painted on because it is on the sleeve as opposed to like this having it sculpted on. And the tights. Yeah, the tights, again, a lot of similarities. Oh, right here. There it is. There's the big difference. There's another real big difference because if you look right here, this kind of has like the lady garment style, right? With the crisscross, and this just has the black flame style to it. So the masks, yeah, they did end up going with the exact same masks. Great choice. I feel like this one has like a glossier finish to it, and this one has more like a matte finish. So great looking figure, I'm telling you. The one thing that they did not include, which I wish they would have, was this he used to use this because the man couldn't talk, right? He got burnt as a child. Eventually, we found out that the man could not only talk, but let's not get into that. So it would have been cool had they include this, but still, I mean, I'll take this over a $70 figure, right? And let's put the gold on him because this is hands down probably his best run. In my eyes, Kane's best run was definitely when he was with the Dead Man, right? And this looks cool because if you got your Undertaker waiting at home for Kane, look at this. This just looks awesome. I love this a lot. Nothing like the Brothers of Destruction destroying your collection, right? Until next time, everybody.